Hello and praise God, boys and girls. Hope you're doing well. It's Teacher Esther here. I hope you are keeping safe wherever you are and you're doing what is required for you as a child of God. Let us pray as we start our lesson. Oh God, we are coming before you this morning to give you thanks, to give you praise, oh dear Lord Father. We give you thanks for the gift of life, oh God. Father, thank you for enabling us to be here again, O dear Lord Father, to hear from you, O God. May you open our ears, O dear Lord Father. May you open our hearts, O dear Lord Father, so that we may hear from you, O God. Bless us, O dear Lord Father, from this time, O dear Lord Father, till the end. This I pray, trusting and believing. Amen.
Everything I am.
Everything I am.
All you've given me.
All you've given me.
I give it to you, Lord. And do thankfully, every song I sing, every praise I bring, everything I do is a gift to you. Everything I am,
everything I am,
all you've given me,
all you've given me,
I give it to you, Lord.
I give it to you, Lord.
And do thankfully, every song I sing, every praise I everything I do is a gift to you. Everything I am,
everything I am,
all you've given me,
all you've given me,
I give it to you, Lord.
I give it to you, Lord.
And do it thankfully. Every song I sing, every praise I bring, everything I do is a gift to you. Everything I am, all you've given me,
all you've given me,
I give it to you, Lord.
I give it to you, Lord.
And do it thankfully. Every song I sing, every praise I bring, everything I do is a gift to you.
Our lesson today comes from the book of Esther, chapter number 1 to chapter 10. We are going to narrate the story. In this story, we are going to learn that God has made us special. We are going to learn that we are very valuable to Him, and He has given us special gifts and strength. Here comes the story. This story is about a Jewish orphan girl who was very special to God. Most of us know the story, so let us listen carefully and attentively. God had something very important that He needed done, and He chose a Jewish orphan girl to do it. Her name was Esther. Esther was a beautiful orphan, given living in a foreign land. The king of this land was looking for a new queen. He called for all the young women in the land to come to his palace so he could choose his queen. Esther was one of the women taken to the palace. But she kept the fact that she was Jewish a secret. Esther and the other young women stayed at the palace and had beauty treatment for almost a whole year. They waited for their chance to have a time alone with the king. Esther finally had a time alone with the king. She pleased him so much that he chose her as his new queen. Later, a powerful man called Haman, who worked with the king, wanted to kill all the Jews in the land. Sadly, he tricked the king into allowing him to do it. Remember, the king did not know Esther was a Jewish. Esther's cousin Mordecai told Esther to beg the king for mercy to save her Jewish people. Esther was very afraid to tell the king that she was a Jewish. She knew she might be killed too. However, she gathered up courage and talked to the king. The Bible tells us what happened. The king promised whatever Esther asked for, she will be given. She said, "If I please you, Your Majesty, please save my life and please save my people's lives. This is what I want. There is a law that you signed that will cause me and all my people to be killed. None of us will be left." The king had no idea what she was talking about until she told him she was a Jewish. "What do you think the king did? He saved her life and the lives of all the Israelites. Haman, who was behind the plot to kill Jews, was killed instead. God raised up the little orphan girl. Esther to very important position of queen. It was no accident that Esther became a queen. God had a purpose for her. He used Esther to save the Jewish people. It was up to Esther to decide whether she will play the part that God offered her. She decided to have courage and even risk her life to follow God and save her people. The king loved Esther, listened to her opinion, and protected her. God must have been pleased with the king's action. God wants men to treat women with respect. God loves women and men the same. Just like men, God uses women like Esther to do great things. Amen. This is a story about an orphan girl. She's called Esther. We see that she became a queen. She did not know she will be a queen. And in this process, a man called Haman appeared to the king and told him to kill the Jewish. And Esther had so she was afraid at first, but she gathered courage and she faced the king, and the king saved their lives. Today morning, I want to tell you, boys and girls, that we are all special. God made us special just like Queen Esther. God made us special the day he created us. He made us in his own image, and we are fearfully and wonderfully made in his image. God made us special, boys and girls. I want to tell you this morning that it doesn't matter where you're coming from. It doesn't matter what you are at now. But if God has a purpose for you, he will surely do great things. In this story, we see that Esther had a strength, and this strength is brave. She was brave. She came up courageously to face the king. And today morning, I want to tell you that God has a purpose for us. He has a purpose for me and you. He knows the future of us. And he has given us strength, of which our parents will help us to identify the strength. Esther had that strength, and she came out courageously. What about you? What about you, boy and girl? You have this special gift. You have this special strength that God will surely do a great thing. Do a great thing in the future. Maybe you want to be a pilot. You want to be an engineer. You want to be a doctor. And you think you will not be. God is telling you this morning that you will become what you want. He has the future for us. He has plans for us in the future. And boys and girls, if you are a girl, today I want to tell you that girls, we are queens, and boys, we are kings. And that's the lesson for today. So let us go straight to the memory verse for today. Memory verse for today comes from the book of Jeremiah, chapter 29, verse 11. It says, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future." Boys and girls, repeat after me, Jeremiah chapter 29, verse 11. "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future." And that's very true, boys and girls. God has a future for us. And we are made special since day one. As we finish, let us say this prayer together. Dear Lord, thank you for making us so special and giving us different strength. You have a purpose for each life. Thank you that you have great plans for our future, and that you will take care of us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.